Hi, my name's Costas.
I'm Chris.
Welcome to the fifth episode of the weekly magazine.
Episode five.
Here we go.
Where did the time go?
You flew by. And what are you doing?
Well, I was making a point.
Magic now.
Yeah. We've got another winner.
Well, next week you're going to be wearing a hoodie so you don't do any crazy stuff like that. It's
crazy.
Insulting to the brand.
What? Okay, so we've got a winner. We've got four winners for last week's word. And
yeah.
The word was...
Chicken.
Chicken. Well spotted.
You can tell I lived in a village.
Every village has got one. So, right. And the winner is Baz the Magician.
Excellent. I'll Facebook you and we'll sort this out.
We'll send you 20 quid.
Yeah, not sure exactly what it is yet, but we'll make sure it's good. We'll actually contact you to see what you might like so we can sort something out.
So well done, Baz.
There's no competition this week.
No, because?
Because we're going to have one next week or the week after. We're actually, it's a break next week. We're going to have a show next week. Are we?
Yeah, we are.
Okay, well, I'll bring you in so we can do the show. But just in case you are not able to come in, we won't do a competition.
Yeah, I'm on
just
holiday.
In case.
He's let me have some time off. Right, so what are we looking at this week, Costas, on the show?
We've got a fantastic effect, really impressed me, which is Dream Prediction by Paul Rimhany.
Excellent. And also Ryan Schultz's Effortless Effects. And the blast from the past this week is...
In a Flash by Jay Sankey.
Okay. Thank you. See you in a bit.
The first trick on the Once Over this week is Dream Prediction by Paul Rimhany. Now let's go and see the live performance and then we come back and discuss it.
So, come back to that in a second.
Right.
Actually, I'll use you for this, Rachel. What I want you to do is I want you to imagine that you're going on your dream holiday. Okay, you can go anywhere in the world. Where would that be?
Mauritius.
Something I can't spell.
Yeah,
thank you.
Say that.
Sorry.
That's all right. So I'll write Mauritius down on the pad. And I'll write holiday as well, so you know what we're talking about later on. So how much would this holiday cost you, including spending money and everything, the dream holiday? How much would you want to spend on it, presuming you had as much money? You know, any amount of money, basically.
Let's go 10,000.
10,000? Wow, cool. Okay, so 10,000. And I'll write amount so we know what we're talking about. Okay. And finally, who would you take?
My husband.
Simon. Okay. Yeah.
That's
I was going to say.
Yeah.
Would you have said that if he wasn't here? And I'll write take as well so we know. Yeah, you wouldn't have said that if he was here, would you? You'd have said, what, John Bon Jovi or something like that, would you? Yeah, you're too young, actually.
David Beckham.
Perfect. Have you got the tattoos, Simon?
No.
So I've wrote that down here, okay, everything that you just said.
Yeah.
And this was basically here the whole time,
mm-hmm.
Right? Do you want to read out what my prediction was?
On holiday in Mauritius, you will spend 10,000 and take Simon. That's amazing.
That's brilliant.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
Dream prediction.
Yes.
Now, when I first saw this, watched the trailer, didn't really think much of it.
Really?
Yeah, it's just, okay, confabulation effects. Okay, yeah, great. They're great to know, great to do. This one in particular, it just passed me by because I thought, there's nothing really in this. And I think it's because the official trailer didn't really give much either.
Okay, yeah.
But when we've played around with this,
yeah,
it's fantastic.
I performed it to you tonight in the shop, and it's a real fooler.
It is. It's
the handling's nice and clean. Let's have a look. Should we have a look at what you get?
Yeah.
So you get the DVD, really well explained how to.
He does a great job explaining everything.
Yeah, he shows you, basically, he talks you through how to set up everything. There's some live performances. And he also encourages you to go out and find your own performance for this. He talks about holiday, and he's got three predictions. So one's the destination, how much money, and who they're going to take.
Yeah.
So that's all explained on the DVD. Now this isn't gimmicked.
It's a it's a great size though.
It isn't gimmicked, but it's been made specifically for this effect. Okay, so Alan Wong's done a great job with these.
Yeah.
So you get the envelope here, which has got your prediction in, somewhere to put your pen, and there's somewhere to put the pad. Okay, so and that's all you need. And the reset on this is pretty much instant. Okay, Paul Rimhany, he uses this table hopping. And you get some spare envelopes to make up more gimmicks.
It's not that much bulky, really, to
a card to wallet.
No. Is it? You have it inside your jacket pocket.
Yeah, or it'll sit in your trouser pocket or your back trouser pocket quite comfortably. I had it in my back jeans pocket earlier when I was performing it.
It actually doesn't really feel uncomfortable. It doesn't feel uncomfortable.
And the thing is, with anything, any leather product, it's going to soften with age.
This hasn't really been used much, so it is a bit stiff. Even though it's still, you know, when you get it, it's still soft leather. It's still got loads of aging to do.
And make it even that's going to last you a long time, right? The envelopes are going to wear out, but having said that, they're going to last you a while. You get 10. There's no refills yet available that we know of yet.
I'm sure they will become available. You do get
10
envelopes, but you don't need an envelope every performance.
No.
You just need to replace the envelope when it gets a bit of wear and tear.
And the nice thing about this is I've set this one up with my business card. Yeah. So every time I perform this routine, the spectator's going to get one of my business cards with an impossible souvenir on the back. In fact, they get two souvenirs. They get your business card, and also you tear this out and you give them this with the predictions on there.
There's a lot I like about this trick. Apart from the reactions, they can tell when the live performance, the performance that we, when you performed it live, the reaction was just outstanding.
It's impossible, isn't it? And I mean, there's a train of thought that it's too impossible. Some people say, you should have at least one miss. I've never gone along with that too perfect theory, personally. I think we're doing the impossible, so it might as well be impossible.
Sometimes I think it depends on the trick as well. You know, with this three direct hits is really strong.
It is strong.
I don't think it would be stronger by having a miss or something.
I think it's meant the mentalist community. How can I put this? The mentalism is still one of those things that people. People still think it could be the extrasensory perception.
Yeah,
could be real, right? So what mind readers, they approach it slightly differently, I think. And, you know, they put the odd miss in there to make it more credible when they get a hit, and I suppose. But from looking at this from a magician's point of view, then,
But I've never really found it a problem, you know, especially with confabulation as well, you know, because you're asking them, you know, three questions, and it ends up being written on the business card.
I've just got to say, if you've got a confabulation routine, or a prop for confabulation that you're happy with, then obviously you don't need to buy this product, really. And that's a fair comment.
I do think a lot of magicians don't have a confabulation routine, especially the newer generation of magicians.
It's always been known as a cabaret routine.
But this is a close-up effect.
And this is designed for close-up work.
You can perform this at every table.
The reset is instant. You've just got to put another business card into the little wallet here.
I guess the only thing you do need, there is a bit of arts and crafts with this. You have to make up, build the gimmick.
Yeah.
You get everything that you need, of course, but you've got to play around with it and make sure the gimmick is...
You took a little bit of experimentation on our part.
We're going to have a brief video as well, whoever buys it from Magic Dale, some pointers that we've discovered whilst putting this together. But once you've done it, you know exactly what you're doing.
Yeah.
Won't go explain any more.
I don't want to give too much away. Don't want to give too much away, but...
And give credit to Roger Curson as well.
Yeah.
Great idea, and...
So, as far as I'm concerned, it's an absolute winner. You need to, you know, it's very easy to do, although you do need to rehearse. But, yeah, for me, it's as strong as it gets, really.
But you didn't rehearse it that much before you showed it to me, and I couldn't see anything. I couldn't see, how you got it in the envelope. Even though, okay, we know what it was, but it wasn't obvious. It was very, very, very clean.
I like it. I'll give it it's definitely recommended from me.
Absolutely. Yeah. And me as well. It's just fantastic, a fantastic routine.
So that's Dream Prediction, the Elite Close-Up Version by Paul Rimhany and Alan Wong. So the next item on the Once Over this week is Effortless Effects by Ryan Schultz. It's a DVD that was released with Big Blind Media. So I'm just going to show you one of the routines off the DVD, and then we'll talk a little bit about it. So we're going to use the four aces for this. We'll come back to those in a second. They're going to help me to find your card. And what I want you to do for me, Costas, you're going to take a few cards. So if you just want to touch one, that one there, and another one here, another one, another one.
This one.
And one more.
This one.
Perfect. Okay, so do you want to go ahead and take those cards? Brilliant. And what I want you to do for me is just sort of mix them up a little bit like this. Okay, so I can't possibly know any order.
Yeah.
And I want you to split through those and have a look. And I want you to remember one of those cards. So make it one that's going to stick in your mind. So perhaps go for the highest card in the hand there. Okay, have you got it?
Yeah.
Fantastic. And I'd like you to just drop them back in there for me. Wonderful. So, it would be easy for me to run through and possibly find your card, right? But I said I was going to get the aces to do this. So could I just borrow your hand just for a second? Fantastic, we can leave the aces here. Like that, brilliant. Okay, so first of all, I want you to concentrate on the suit of your card. Have you done that? We're going to send it down to the aces. Okay, let's have a look. Right, so one of the cards is turned face down, it's the ace of clubs. So I'm thinking your card was a club, is that correct?
That's correct.
So now we're going to go for the value, if you want to send that down as well. What card did you...
King of clubs.
The king of clubs. Let's have a look at this cost. The ace of clubs actually changes into the king of clubs. Thank you. So that's just one of the routines on the DVD Effortless Effects by Ryan Schultz.
I really like that.
Yeah, it's great.
It fooled me badly. I had no idea.
No.
Absolutely no idea.
Every time, when I watched the DVD through, pretty much every effect on there was a fooler, right?
Yeah.
He teaches a principle on there, not in that particular routine, called the gap principle.
Gap principle.
Now, I'd never seen this before, and he absolutely fried me with it. And then I went on and did it to you and fried you with it, right? And the amount of work that's in there, the tricks are fairly easy. They're not, I wouldn't say they're self-working.
But at the same time, they're not that difficult to master.
No.
Especially this one. Yes, that you're not going to learn it within a couple of minutes.
Well, there's a couple of moves in there, but they're very straightforward.
But that's it.
But the one, the routines using that gap principle are pretty much self-working, right? Pretty much.
I would buy this DVD for this trick alone and not bother with the gap principle, because this trick is really, really strong.
I like the gap principle. I thought it was good.
No, it is good. Well, however, if you buy the DVD and just learn one trick and just learn this, you're more than paid for the DVD.
I've smoked a few magicians with it since I've learned it, to be honest.
You know, really in magic, you see so much magic, and you say tricks. Yeah, that's okay, that's good. It's nice. It's a nice feeling when you get completely fooled by a trick. And this was that moment where I had no idea, and I had to chuckle to myself when I found out what the magic.
Do you know
was.
The thing about when you're a magician or you're interested in magic? Sometimes you forget what it's like to feel like a lion yeah. again. But just think how I feel, because I can't put the DVD on and learn it's done. yeah. I go away thinking, and then I never find out how it's done. But yeah, I mean, watching some of those routines, it does make you feel like a lion again. And the way you feel all the magicians, it's not using double lifts and sleight of hand, it's using clever, well-constructed stuff like this.
And I liked Ryan's performance and explanation style.
Yeah, seems like a really nice guy, actually.
It was really well paced and it was really good.
I thought it was brilliant. I thought it was fantastic. I mean, you know, I would definitely recommend this DVD to anyone.
Yeah.
The sort of stuff that you do, it's something that you, once you remember, once you've got that trick, that's going to be with you forever, right? It's easy. Brilliant.
Well, you showed it to on Tuesday when we did the dealer dem in Leicester.
Yeah.
And you performed it to a couple of really well-known magicians, card magicians, and
fooled them.
It fooled them. They had no idea.
Fool anybody with it. Fool down on the principle. So brilliant DVD, Ryan. Well done. Recommended from me.
Fantastic. So this week's question is: what's your thought on practice?
Yeah, got quite a mixed response, really. Do you still practice? And first of all, let me ask you, do you practice?
No.
Okay.
There is a reason behind that. I'm not a full-time performer, you know, too busy running a magic business.
I don't think that makes any difference.
And I haven't got, you know, when you come into work at 7:30 in the morning and leave at 7:00, you go home at night, you eat, and then you might do some more work, then you haven't got time for practice.
Okay.
However, occasionally I might get out a book or something and go through some material and learn something new. Of course, if we're working on a project, I'm always playing with that.
Yeah.
But I don't practice religiously just to keep my hand in, because I go out performing and I need to be on the ball all the time.
Yeah. There's two things that came out from this. And the main thing is there was a distinction between practice and rehearsal. Okay.
Yeah, there was, wasn't
there? In other words, practicing a sleight, practicing a move, and a rehearsal of a routine. Okay, so that was quite an important distinction. And I'll give you some of the responses. James Fortune, who's a working professional in the UK, says he works all the time, so he doesn't practice. He uses the same routines every show, children's shows, cabaret, and close-up.
Well, that's actually
so good. He's well-honed and he doesn't need to practice.
Coming back to my question, do I practice? If I was going to be booked for a gig, I will go through my set. Because I'm not polished enough, because I don't do it every day.
Well, that's rehearsal, isn't it?
So effectively, it's rehearsal rather than practicing, just to get back into the flow of things.
Yeah. So Paul Gordon, who I think Paul these days, he does a lot of lecturing and a lot of conventions and stuff. I think he still does do some performance to lay audiences. I'm not sure whether that's what I think he does mainly for magicians these days. And he says he still practices quite often. Now, Damien Sir, again, he says he doesn't practice that much because he performs a lot. He'll rehearse a new routine. And then basically, once he's got that routine in there, he will then go and do it at a gig. And the fine-tuning will
come with it.
Which is a really good point. Yeah. Okay, he's performing a lot. Now, John Carey, great card man, as we know, he does a sleight drill 3 or 4 times a week for an hour.
I found that an interesting response, actually. And that is dedication for you, isn't it? And hence why John Carey is good.
Yeah.
You know, he's on the ball all the time. You know, he's slides are to perfection. Whereas, you know, if I was to do a slide, sometimes it might be sloppy because I haven't got that rehearsed as much as John Carey.
But what John does is he'll do it, and this is what I do when I'm practicing. If I'm practicing a move or a slide, you don't sit there doing that and nothing else. John says he does it when he's got some music on the radio or he's watching something on the TV. And I find that's what works best for me as well. If I'm watching something on the TV, I'll have a pack of cards or a coin or whatever it is, and I'll just practice. And that way you get the muscle memory and you do it without.
And also it becomes more natural, isn't it? It's when you're looking, when you're doing something, you're looking at your hands doing it. It doesn't become natural because, the perfect example, if you've got a tray with a cup of coffee and you're going to take it to the table,
yeah,
you never look at the tray because you spill the coffee. So you just look at where you're going and you never spill it. And same with practicing a move or something.
Absolutely.
If you're watching and doing something else at the same time, it becomes more natural.
You watch a good performer. Any good performer, right? And this is an old thing. This goes back to Ramsey, probably before that. And John, Dave Jones, drilled this into me many years ago, right? If you want the audience to look at what you're doing,
yeah,
you look at it. If you want them to look at you, you look at them, okay? But basically, if you're just shuffling a pack of cards, this is, you know, this is what I do. I'll be doing a riffle shuffle or whatever. But I'll be doing it. I won't even be looking at the cards. Okay, so that's the important thing. So let's have a few more. Now, we had a really fantastic response from Lee Thompson. Now, Lee puts in his quote, and it's quite funny, you know, a lot of people won't know who I am because I haven't got a DVD out. Let me tell you, Lee, he's one of the most well-known professionals in the UK. He works at Cirque du Soleil, Moulin Rouge. He does a pickpocket act.
He's had some of the most prestigious gigs in the world, hasn't
he? He goes all over the world doing his pickpocket act, right? Now, he basically put a big, long reply, and it's too long to go into here. I'll give you basically what he says is he practices, he works 5 or 6 times a week, and yet he still practices and rehearses every day. Now, he did publish an essay all about, it's called Don't Forget to Breathe. And it's in his works, his pickpocket workshop lecture notes.
Yeah.
So if anybody's interested in reading that essay, it was fascinating stuff, you need to get in touch with Lee Thompson and beg, borrow, steal, or even buy a copy of those notes. All right, so it was a fantastic response from Lee. Unfortunately, it was too long to read it. A few more then. Ian Kendall, I will practice something every day. Brian Alexander, every day. John O'Riordan, practice is important, rehearsal is essential. And I thought that was a fantastic point to finish on. I'll say it again, it's important. Practice is important, but rehearsal is essential. So some fantastic replies this week, thank you very much indeed. And the question for next week's show is, what do you think the public's perception
is of magicians or magic?
So that's it for the question and answers for this week. Thank you very much.
This week's Blast from the Past is In a Flash by Jay Sankey. Now let's go and have a look at Chris performing this and then come back and discuss it.
Rachel, do you want to just take one? Anyone?
That one.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. Have a look. Show it to Simon, show it to the camera. And do you want to write your name nice and big on the face? Done that?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. Right, it doesn't matter if I see it. It's not that kind of a trick, right? In fact, I'm going to leave it in there, right in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Have you got a 10 pence piece at all, or shall we use mine?
I haven't got one.
Oops, I'll throw it at you. There you go. Pop it down there. What I want you to do, pop your initials on there. So I want you to know that this is your 10 pence later on. Brilliant. And I'm going to use a little bit of tissue paper as well. Fantastic, right. So, basically what we do, pop this on here.
Whoa.
Oh, all the way through. Stop to that card. Turn it over.
Oh, amazing.
That's brilliant.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
In a flash.
In a flash.
I have to admit, this trick is one of my all-time favourite effects. I think...
It's fire.
It's one of Jay Sankey's best ever releases. And, you know, it was around when we were going out performing and stuff. So it was one of these things that we used in the real world at the time. Got great reactions, and it sort of, you know, it stuck with us. It's just a fantastic...
Well, it's been around for years. The fact that people are still using it now just shows you how good it is, really, doesn't it? Well, basically anything that uses fire is good. You know, as long as you're responsible with it, you know. But yeah, it's incredibly clever, well-routined.
It's easy to do, and the outcome is just great. You know, imagine, you know, a fire, half the cards have got a hole in.
Mm. Yeah, actually, that's a good point. If you've got the older version of this, the holes were perfectly...
Yeah, the perfectly circular.
Circular holes, which for me, I can't see that as being a problem. However, the new version, realistic looking burnt cards, so the holes are a bit more jaggy. So I guess it does look a little bit more...
a bit more authentic, I guess, yeah.
So that, you know, for anybody who's got the older version, would like to update to the newer version. But yeah, basically, if you like the look of this, it's very easy to do. The reactions are amazing. You just need to get yourself some flash paper, and away you go.
Yeah, I think in a flash is a perfect example, because you speak to quite a few magicians that are people that come into magic recently, and they wouldn't have heard of in a flash, even though it was such a very popular, successful product released by Jay Sankey.
It's been out a while. It's been out about 8 or 9 years. Something.
I would say it must have been before or around 2003.
Yeah. So 10 years probably.
So over 10 years.
Mm.
If not longer, because I remember I brought it, and it was packaged in a grip seal bag.
Yeah, I remember.
With paper instructions.
In little bags like that, yeah.
And it was, I can't remember.
Oh, these were the days before DVDs, weren't
they? We had to learn by reading.
Get to read a piece of paper.
Yeah.
No. So, in a flash, we'll check it out. It's great.
It's, if you want a bit of fire and a great magic trick, in a flash. Today is the worldwide release for Grant Maidment's Your Card Is, so all pre-orders will start being shipped today. If you haven't picked this up, have a look at it again. We're getting some great feedback from working pros using this in their repertoire. And Chris Congreve is walking past as though I'm not here filming, so I just pretend and ignore him. He doesn't exist. Also, all Magic Dow customers ordering Dream Prediction will get a download giving you some hints and pointers of what we encountered during this, putting this trick together. And there's Chris again. You might as well go and make the coffee and be ready. This also comes with double reward points as well. And this is only going to be valid until this time next week, next Friday. And due to the nature of the price of this effect, you'll automatically get free delivery, and the free delivery, unfortunately, is UK only. And that's it for this week, and we'll see you next week. Thank you very much.
Here's the bit I don't understand. If I just go like this, do you see the Joker's change? Not on this side, actually on the other side. Go on. So we've got a few jokers here, and I can see there's a couple of jokers here as well.
Okay.
I'm going to turn from face down to face up. You won't catch me doing it. Watch closely. Just square the sides like this. That was the first one. That was the first one. I'll do it again. Just wave over. And Now there's two face up, two face down. Another wave. So you're doing all of this. But watch the last one, right to the very last minute.
Just like a magician.
You are a magician. We've all got a bit of magic inside of us. See, that's when they all turn the face the same way. But hold out your hand, please, sir. Put your thumb on top so they don't blow away. With your other hand, just wave over the jokers. See, I'm not even touching the cards. And look, you turned over one. I don't know how you're doing this, mate. It's the blue top. I think that's how it's done. Put your thumb on top. Here's the bit I don't understand. If you take the jokers, just go like that. Did you see them change?
Not really.
You see them change?
I didn't.
They changed, look. But here's the bit I don't understand. Do you remember the colours at the backs were?
Red.
And now they were all different.
What? That is so confusing.
Yeah, I still haven't worked that out yet.
No. It's going to come be fun.
What?
What? What the heck? Does it make sense?
No.